Hi guys, my name is Lillian Onwebuna. Welcome to my YouTube channel. So today I will be making jollof rice. This my jollof rice is so precious to me. Like my jollof rice is so yummy, if I do say so myself. I don't mean to brag, but allow me to brag. It's actually so good. And today I will be letting you in on my secret ingredients on how to get that fantastic, delicious jollof rice. During the course of this video, I'll be letting you in on that my special ingredient. Yeah, I will be making chicken, I will be making spicy peppered goat meat. Right here, I'll be making it with all of these ingredients. This is my garlic and ginger. I have some here too. This is my little secret to a delicious jollof rice. I will be telling you what this is during the course. I mean, you can see that it's stock, but we don't know what kind of stock I have in here. I'll be letting you in on that during the course of this video. And this is my blended pepper mix. In here, I have tomatoes, tatashe, and atarodo. That is a habanero pepper. Yeah, I have it in here. I always have this in my fridge. It makes cooking easier for me because I use it most for like everything. I use it for beans, I use it for jollof rice, I use it for pasta, like if I'm making creamy tomato pasta, or I'm making Nigerian spaghetti. I use it for everything, so I always like to have this in my fridge. It makes cooking easier for me. So yeah, I will start with cutting up this chicken, season it and boil it. Yeah, so let's get started.
Listen for the best. My reputation's never been worse, so you must like me for me. We can't make any promises now, can we, babe? But you can make me drink. Dive bar on the east side, where you at? Phone lights at my nightstand in the black. Come here, you can meet me in the back. Look at you, oh damn, never seen that color blue. Just think of the fun things we could do. Cause I like you. Listen for the best. My reputation's never been worse, so you must like me for me. Yeah, I want you. We can't make any promises now, can we, babe? But you can make me.
This is the seasoning cube I use. This is curry and thyme. I use this to season my meat. I also use it to make the base for the jollof rice. And this is my bay leaf and pepper. I don't bother blending or cutting. Everything will So guys, our chicken is now cooked and it's time to start the base for the jollof rice. So what we need from here, the reason we waited for this chicken to cook is so we can use the stock.
So add our vegetable oil. So once this oil heats up, we will proceed. So now the hot oil has heated up, I will add the onion. I won't be using everything. Add the onion. Followed by garlic and ginger. And I will pour in bay leaf. The bay leaf. I will allow this to fry for a little while before I proceed with the other things. So next I'll be adding tomato paste. I'm using Derica. You can use anyone, I guess. I usually just buy anyone I see. I don't use anyone in particular. You turn that, give it a good stir. And allow it to fry. I'm going to allow this to fry for like 10 minutes or 10-20 minutes. It needs to fry very well, and also the color will change a little bit before I proceed in adding pepper mix, the tomato, satashi, and pepper. So next I will be going in with my pepper mix. So this has been frying for a while now, so I'm going to go ahead and start putting all the other ingredients. This is my seasoning cubes. In here I have beef, I have no beef seasoning cube, and I have chicken seasoning cubes in here. I like to mix it like that. Then the salt, the curry, and thyme. So I'm going to transfer this into a bigger pot. So my I usually like to do my base in this smaller pan, because this smaller saucepan, because of my burner, it's really small. It won't take the big pot. So when I'm done frying it here, I will transfer it into a bigger pot where I'll be cooking the jollof rice. So the reason I do that is that one, that big pot, jollof rice doesn't need too much heat to cook. It just literally needs to steam. So that's why I like to fry it in this smaller pan. Then I'll transfer to the big pot when it's time to pour in the rice and cook it here. So it doesn't require too much heat to cook. But this base requires heat to cook. So that's why I do my base in a smaller pan. Yeah, so I'll be transferring it into a bigger pot now. So I'm transferring into a bigger pot. This is where I'll be making the jollof rice. So if you have a big burner, you can use your big pot from start to finish. You don't need to fry your base separately. You can use your big pot and fry it and then proceed with every other thing. You don't need to do what I just did now. So I will sieve the chicken stock into the fried tomatoes. If you do not also want to sieve, it's also fine. Nothing, it doesn't change anything. and it's time for our secret ingredients. Yay! This right here, this is my beef stock. Beef stock is the secret ingredient to my jollof rice. It takes it from, let me say, if chicken stock would give it 50, it takes it from 50 to 100. Beef stock does wonders to my jollof rice. I would really like you to try this and tell me what you think about it. So I'm going to give this a good mix and then I will cover it and allow it to boil before we add our washed rice. So while this is boiling, I'm going to go ahead and wash the rice I'll be using. Been boiling for a while now. I'm going to go ahead and pour in our washed rice. Give this a good mix. Once the water starts going down, I'm going to proceed to the next step. Okay guys, so the rice is ready. I'm going to turn it a little bit. Then I will cover it with a foil so it will steam. At this point, it needs steaming to completely cook. So and we will wait for it to cook. This is like the last step. In another 10-15 minutes, this should be ready. See you soon. Okay, so this has been cooking for a while now and it's done. I believe it's done. I'll give this a good stir. Ooh. And I'll be adding this to the butter. Allow it to dissolve before I come back to turn it. So our rice is ready.
Okay.
So good. You should totally try this recipe. It will take your jollof rice from, let me say, 70 to 100%, I tell you. So guys, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more yummy recipes. Bye guys!